Hey everybody, this is David Dugdale, learningvideo.com. I thought I'd give you guys an update on my beast computer that I built with JJ last year, about a year ago. About a month or two after he left, started crashing. And it wasn't like a bad crash, if crash can be bad. But basically what happened is I put the computer to sleep, walk away, about 10 minutes later, it would crash. Either it would turn all the way off, or it would do something funky that it couldn't recover from, and I'd have to reboot it. Wasn't that big of a deal. It happened maybe once or twice a week. And so through the spring of this year, I was working with JJ trying to resolve the issue. It was hard to resolve because it's an intermittent problem. It doesn't happen every single time. So in the summer, it started getting worse. And I said, okay, let's start to maybe, because I had done a fresh clean install of Windows 7 back then. And then since then, I've put Windows 10 on here. So I'm pretty confident it's not the drivers, the software, or any of that stuff. I'm starting to think, or JJ and I were thinking, it was either the motherboard or the power supply. So he put in a request, I guess, to their shipping department to send me out some more equipment. But it's been several months, maybe 4 or 5 months since then, and I haven't seen anything. So I went ahead and to B&H and I said, hey, can you just loan me some stuff? I'm gonna try, see if I can fix this problem my own. This is the same board that I got in there right now, but this is the 3.1 version, so it's a little bit newer. So it might be motherboard related, because it seems to be a lot of these issues are dealing with USB. Sometimes the mouse and the keyboard will just stop working altogether. Some weird power stuff going on with the USB, so I'm not exactly sure. But I thought while I was opening up the case, I would also install this. This is a GTX 980 Ti. This has about twice as many CUDA cores as my current 680 in there. So I've run a bunch of baseline experiments already with the 680 before I take this apart, and we're gonna put these two things in, and we're gonna look to see, A, if it solves my problem, because lately it's been crashing 3 times a day, and not just when I put it to sleep, like I'm in Premiere, it just gives me a blue screen of death crash. I have to reboot it and get back into my program. I've lost, 10 minutes of work. It's just been a pain in the butt. So after swapping out the motherboard, I went and put it to sleep to see if it would do the same issue, and it did the same issue. I got the same driver power state failure, blue screen of death error. It's just very frustrating. I feel like it's Groundhog's Day, where the day keeps repeating, like as in I'll go research the problem on the internet, find somebody that had a solution. I'll try the solution thinking, yeah, I got it. I'll get out of this endless day and I'll get out of this problem. And boom, it keeps repeating. So it sounds like this problem is very different for other people. Other people have solved it in different ways, and I go to try their solution and it just doesn't work for me. So that's why I keep thinking it's more hardware related. So we know it's not the motherboard, or at least I'm pretty sure it's not the motherboard. So I might move on to the power supply next. So basically I've got 162 drivers on my machine, and I've used two different programs to go through and check. And I did find some outdated ones, because if you go through Device Manager and you go through each individual one, and it'll say it's up to date, but then you use other programs and they'll find outdated drivers. And I've updated all of them and it's still crashing. So I don't know what to do. If you guys have any suggestions, are there any computer geniuses out there, or somebody's had this particular problem before and fixed it, let me know, because I'll definitely try your solution, even though it feels like Groundhog's Day. So basically what happens is, if I go to put it to sleep, it'll go to sleep, and about usually 2 to maybe 10 minutes later, it'll create this error and the whole computer will shut down. Or like what happened just a few minutes ago, where I went to just power the system down totally, like it would say restarting and it's just stuck on the restarting screen. And then about, 10 minutes into it, it just gets the driver power state failure. blue screen of death, and then it just turns itself off. And then also, like, what I'm in Premiere Pro, and I'm not, like, power cycling or anything, I'm in Premiere Pro, and I'm, like, scrubbing the timeline, I'm playing, or I'm doing something. It's usually after maybe an hour or so of editing, and it'll just crash, which can be very frustrating. Sometimes the, like, when I start it up, or wake it up from sleep mode when it does work, sometimes the keyboard will not work. Like I'll try to enter something and nothing's happening. So it's almost like it's a USB, it's a power related issue. So maybe next it's the power supply to replace that. So again, I've done a fresh, clean install on Windows 7. I've updated to Windows 10 twice because actually when I put the new motherboard in, I lost the activation because it, I guess Windows 10 is based off of the unique identifier on the motherboard. And so I had actually call Microsoft and they actually had to download it on my machine in a different way because most people, I guess, don't replace their motherboards. So yeah, I'm still having this issue. So if anybody could help out, please, that would be awesome. I would really appreciate it. Thank you very much. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.